guys, and welcome to Spider Mcgavenport's channel. This time, Rygar. Go ahead, take it apart, clean those contact pads on it, and then test it out inside the control deck. This is a non-revision A cartridge, so it has the standard flathead screws. Yeah. Ever since I saw this particular game featured in the official Nintendo Player's Guide, I had to have it. You know, like, I wanted this game so bad as a kid, and there was only one place where I was able to actually, you know, rent it. So, let's get this lid off here. Oh, sure. That really needed to get cleaned, isn't it? Look at that. That is one gnarly looking board. Yikes. But, as with tradition, let's go ahead and color combination is yellow with yellow, this orange or red, and go with either his shield or the Rygar right there, and then of course the black background. Cool beans. Oh yeah, this thing is just, I mean, this is what I'm talking about for some of the other cartridges, you know, that we were cleaning. And yeah, look at that wear line. Here, I'll flip it over so that you guys can see what it looks like here. An OKI. Has anybody seen that one before? NEC, Sharp. But that's unique versus all the other cartridges that we've been taking apart. That's another really huge solder blob over that H, I'm sure. Is that H? Yeah. Alright, well, let's get busy cleaning this thing up. I'm glad I took it apart, and I'm going to clean it now before putting it inside the console to even see if it plays or anything, because yikes, that is one 8-up cartridge. So my day is going wonderful today. In the comments section below, go ahead, tell me how your day is going. It doesn't matter what date it is, because on YouTube it's non-relevant. Wow. Really catching on the cotton bud here. With this game here, when I was younger, I was like, I couldn't get past the, I'll even show you what I'm talking about. I'm going to move this out of the way real quick. Here's the official Nintendo Player's Guide. I could not get past right here, this one right here, the first one. But eventually I was able to get past it after I figured out that you had to level your character up for a little bit. And then I'd be able to get as far as to Sagila's cave, and that was it. You know, and I was very happy with just getting to Sagila's cave because of the music. The background music of Sagila's cave really, really, I don't know, there's something about it. I really like it a lot. And I remixed it too and made a short video. I added a second channel, or a left or right channel, I can't remember which one it was. And then after, I put a very, very slight echo to it in an audio program that I have on another PC. Yeah, it really, really, really good. Yeah, I like listening to it while I'm playing other games. Well, I'm happy that this doesn't have any, like, damage along here. It just looked really, really gnarly. Okay, I'm zooming in. My greatest concern is right here. That's intact. That's intact. But this one right here, that's why I zoomed it in. That one's intact too. Now this one looks like it's a little messed up. That's when we take them apart and clean them. Cool. Zoom back out. Oh, in the comments section below, tell me what you guys think about this new microphone that I'm using, and the camera too, because this camera is a different camera than what I'm traditionally been using, and the microphone is a lavalier one, lapel microphone. I think it's omnidirectional. That's, I don't know. The last video when I was working on the top loader Nintendo, you know, the control deck, model number NES, Tec 101. It was cleaning on that, and I like the video. I like how much softer this camera is producing these images. It just seems more lifelike than the other one. The other one has more of a I don't know. There's something about it. And the microphone doesn't sound so tinny? Something like that? You guys, go ahead and make a comment down below. You know, tell me what you think. You know, I'm interested in whatever I can do to, you know, help get this information out of how to do this. Because it's very effective. It's, as far as I'm concerned, this is probably the most effective method of getting your Nintendo cartridges to actually play inside the console. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead, and I don't know if we're going to stick with ASMR or not. We'll see. Well, maybe this will be the last time I'm going to go ahead and do that. What do you think? All right, going to ASMR in 3, 2, 1. Thank you. So yeah, with Rygar, there's a trick to playing this particular game, and if you're going to play it, you should most definitely have a controller that is turbo, you know, that has rapid fire built in. The reason why I say that is because you could literally have your character crouch down into a corner and just destroy enemies for about 2-3 hours. You turn the TV off, change channel, whatever you want to do, leave the game running all that time, and you'll level your character up. And that's how I found out how to actually play Rygar, is to not play your character right away, but to do that is to level your character up first, right at the first of the game, like right away at the beginning. You just lean up against the wall and just keep attacking, but it's better to go through the first door and then lean up against the wall there, crouch, have a rubber band and wrap it around your controller or whatever you want to do to your controller to make sure that it's constantly running, and you could level your character up the entire time. And it's like, well, go play a quick game of another game on a different console, or, you know, and I'll watch a couple of YouTube videos. You know, I'm sure all your subscribers would love to see you and hear from you. That's gonna polish up really nice. From what it was to what it is now, wow. Yeah, I really, really, man, I really do swear by this. I mean, and this too, you know, you don't have to do both, but I prefer to make sure that I cover all bases. Make sure I get in between these grooves. Just so that it doesn't smear back over again or contaminate your console. I think there's nothing more annoying than having your console contaminated because your cartridge may or may not have been dirty or grime or grit or something on it. Something very impressive and amazing, actually rather quite astonishing, happened. I have actually been seizure free, that's grand mal seizure free, microleptic seizure free, for 6 full months in a row. Now, I went from having 3 seizures consecutively. Actually, it was originally just 1, and then it went to 2 for a few years. And then it started to go into 3 daily for months there. And then now I'm actually seizure free, and I'm just, I was like, what was causing all of that to happen? Well, for one, I wasn't on the proper medication. Second, I didn't have this right here. Cleaning these and talking about it, really, it's my therapy. It's being able to relax and do this. Give me one second here. I think we are as best we're gonna get it. All right, would you look at that? From how gnarly it was to now. It only took a couple minutes. That is awesome. Yeah, and this one's rather shiny, but there's a couple dull spots here and there. Yeah, let's get this set all cleaned up now too. In the comment section, go ahead and tell me how much or how long you played Rygar or when you were first introduced to it. Because when I first rented this, it was like it was 6 or 7, something like that. And I had the Nintendo running, doing my little trick, the crouch down in the corner and killing monster after monster trick. My parents didn't like that too much. They didn't like the fact that I was leaving my console, or the Nintendo console, on when nobody was at it, kind of thing, you know, like, why would you ever do that? You're just wasting electricity, kind of thing. I was like, no, I'm leveling my character up. And then I found out that I had it on for about 2.5-3 hours. And my mother saw it, and she turned it off because she didn't think I was doing anything. I was like, That just ruined it. Now, of course, the game at that time was a rental. Like, well, that just ruined that whole time frame that I was gonna have to be able to play the game and beat it after that. It's all good, right? Yeah, this should polish up nice. It's going to play immediately in the console. I keep wondering and contemplating which console should I play it on. And I'm thinking I'm going to play it on the control deck. Not the top loader, but the regular control deck. Just because I may want to use the game enhancer. You know, so I can save myself a heap load of time of leveling my character up. We'll see, though. Are we ready for some ASMR? I think you are. 3, 2, 1, Thank you. This one feels very inferior. Yeah, it's weak. No, it's good. I'm super happy by the way this one turned out. Those contact pads look nice for a non-rev, eh? It's the first series. And that one spot looks pretty gnarly yet, but I really. Really not too concerned with it. It still shines right where it needs to. Wonderful. Alright, let's put this game back together again. Let's go ahead and give it a shot and set the console and yeah, see how well it plays. See y'all soon. Hey everybody, I am back. So I just beat Rygar. Use the game enhancer. Here we go, Rygar. Game enhancer. Here are the codes used. Go ahead, hit your pause button. 3, 2, boop. This is invincibility. The next code will be having the first three items of the game. And this is easy HP. Earlier, as I was making the video, this is the spot where I was talking about where you would use a rubber band on your controller and just go ahead and sit here and wait for your stuff to come back. You know, wait a couple hours. 2-3 hours, come back to the game, and you'd see that you'd have more health and a stronger character where it doesn't take two hits to kill those particular enemies.
Rygar has to be one of my top 10 favorite Nintendo games. A lot of it has to do with Sagila's cave and that awesome background music. When I first saw that, it just creeps me out thinking that you're just gonna drop right off of that that pulley. It won't let me crawl. Fine, I'll just use my grappling hook. Here's another part that freaks me out too. It's getting past this doorway right here and how low you have to go. I know you can go around the other direction, but I prefer going this direction. It seems shorter. Thank you. like to say thank you to all my followers on Instagram and on TikTok. And thank you to all my subscribers on YouTube. It's greatly appreciated. And that would be the end of Rygar.
Thank you all so very much for watching. Take care.
Happy gaming.